Hey guys, this presentation is about how to prevent centralina associated bloodstream infections. So let's talk about what is CLABSI. CLABSI is a primary bloodstream infection that develops in patients in a centralina with 48 hours period before the onset of the bloodstream infection that is not related to the infection of another site. What causes CLABSI? Prolonged hospitalization with centralina infection, femoral or internal jugular SS site, the lack of masculosterone barrier for CVC insertions in the ICU or emergency department, heavy microcolonel at the insertion site, and a lack of education and training. So let me ask you a question. As for our burn patients, what do you think the most, what causes CLABSI in our burn patients?
They don't have no skin.
Okay, that's a great question. So they don't have no skin, so they make them prone to more infections, correct? What's another reason why our patients get CLABSI?
Well, our patients get CLABSI because of their length of stay. Burns take a while for it to heal, and the longer you're here, the greater your risk for infection.
Great, great answer. So currently, our hospital policy is nurses' responsibilities. Nurses' responsibility is to perform high-end hygiene, university timeout. All hair should be put up, cap, insert before the insertion site. Position of the patient should be trendelenburg or supine position with the roll towel behind the patient's shoulder, if applicable. Then trachea tube should be covered with a mask or some sort of secretions won't come into play while the centralina is put in. Assist the physician during this time to insert line to maximize sterile barriers. Observe for strict adherence. If there's an observation that the sterile field has been contaminated, you have the right to stop the procedure. It's your responsibility as nurses to make sure that the patient is protected. You're the patient advocate at this time, so it's best that you follow the checklist and make sure that the checklist is being followed as policy. Physicians' responsibilities. We know as nurses that nurses have responsibility and physician also has responsibility. So making sure that the physicians follow the universal protocol timeout and hand hygiene. Hand hygiene is the most important. Making sure that everyone wash their hands. When they change their gloves, they need to wash their hands. When they put on the gloves, they need to wash their hands. That's the most important thing. Maintaining maximum sterile barriers, making sure they got sterile gloves, mask, gowns, and the sterile drapes is over the patient from head to toe. Observe for strict adherence. Prep the skin with antiseptic prior to the catheter insertion site. So what are some of the mistakes y'all see that the doctors make on our unit?
They do not wear masks.
Do that during an emergency or like a routine?
Routine
insertion time?
Yes, they won't wear proper equipment. They just feel that they are so elevated that they just come in and try to not follow protocol and just insert the catheter without.
So do you feel like you have the right to stop it?
Yes, I do feel like I have that right. And I do stop them.
Okay, great. Great reminder. Physician responsibility also. The insertion would be greater than the maximum of 2 attempts. So any physician only have 2 attempts to do the line. If 2 attempts doesn't apply, then they need to get another attendant. So you don't want them to keep on re-sticking your patient. You're the patient advocate. You're there while they're doing the line. So if they do 2 and they unsuccessful, another physician needs to come in the room. If catheter was placed during an emergency and a strict adherence to the aseptic technique cannot be ensured, replace all catheters within 48 hours of the insertion site. So if they get done in an emergency room and emergency situation, we don't know that they did the timeout, the universal protocol. So make sure that the physicians is aware for they can replace a lot within 48 hours. use of subclavian and jugular site in adult patients to maximize infection site. What's the number one site that causes clapsis?
Femoral.
Femoral, because what?
It's so close to the groin.
And all the bacteria and they left. Great answer. Statistics. 80,000 clapsis occurs in the ICU in the United States each year. Between 12 and 25% of patients who require clapsis never leave the hospital. Each year, 250,000 centralized become infected, accounting for an estimated 62,000 hospital deaths in the U.S. Action plan. Our action plan on the burn unit. Create a clapsis champion for each floor, which we did. Educate the champions of the insertion and maintain of the line. The champions are responsible for educating the staff and monthly audits. Check off for old and new employees. So as we started this, we champion. So we have three people that come in, would rotate that do our central line, which have helped our clapsy rate decrease. This is the health system ICA for possible clapsis. So this is the root cause analysis paper that we use sometimes to find out when the line was inserted, what line was inserted, did they follow the checklist, if it was an emergency. So we have to go through the chart and fill out all this. This is the root cause analysis that we have to give our director. Clapsy prevention. Assessing the site every 4 hours for signs of infection and complication. Assessing the necessity of the catheter daily, making sure that if they don't need the catheter, that it get informed the physician and it get deceived. Check for pace of the CBAD, scrub the hub, aspirate for brisk blood return and flush catheter quickly. Flush should be without resistance. If the transparent dressing is used as the initial dressing, it should be changed for all the CBADs every 7 days. So we change our lines every 7 days on Monday midnight, which is Tuesday morning. Place a new stir cap on all stop locks and on the end of IV tubing. So when is the IV tubing changed?
Every Tuesday. Oh wait, every 4 days.
Yeah, every 4 days. Changing tubing, continuous primary and secondary tubing set is every 96 hours. Results. Designated one person CBL dressing changes every Monday. Monthly meeting with the champion. We go every Monday, every month on Fridays to meet with all the champions to see what their problems are, what resolution, what how many clapses we're gonna have for the month. Directly from each floor does the RCA, which has been done. We went from three every month to three for the total of 4 months. Our goal is zero clapsy. Thank y'all for listening to the presentation. And I'm Angela. Thanks.